I am what I am. I am my own special creation.
Hey, Jim.
Sharon.
Welcome back.
Welcome. How are you? Six weeks, girl.
I know.
It's been a long time.
It's
feels like 6 months.
Summer. That's what's happening.
That's it. That's
We're all in different directions.
Absolutely.
Enjoying
Oh, by the way,
weather.
And
yes.
Even my brother has said,
yes.
You look like you've lost weight.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank
I know
you,
that
Phil.
I've lost 7 more pounds.
Yes, I was thrilled for you.
That was great. But
yeah.
You have since January. You were here. You were in my home
yep.
on New Year's Day.
I actually haven't weighed myself, but
you look good.
I've been exercising
well,
quite a bit.
Fabulous.
So tightening up everything.
That's it. So
okay.
now,
okay. What do we got on this show?
On this show, we finally, we won't talk about it, she's been editing for the past 7 months, January's Outlook Awards.
We're now calling it the lost footage.
The lost footage.
Of the
January's
Outlook Awards.
Outlook Awards. And we have a few of the recipients,
yes.
Our own Stephen Seaborg getting
just
the lifetime
montage.
Achievement.
Well, that's all.
And Priscilla Pride unveiled.
Yes.
Her new look and her new
dancing
number.
Dancing queen.
Her debut.
Her debut.
Then we also have Barry Jones-Coppola interviewed
David Kilmnick.
From
the studio, yes.
Long Island Gay and Lesbian Youth. He's
yep.
he's the one in charge of the group, and it's a wonderful interview.
Mm-hmm.
You went, I heard, out east.
I went
east.
Out east, and I was at the Suffolk County Democratic Convention, and there was
mm-hmm.
a little, not a little, it was a nice rally for marriage equality.
Oh, the same-sex marriage equality,
yeah,
right.
Yeah, which was really wonderful, and it was good to see that many people, because apparently, on our last show, Julie and Steve had mentioned that it started out with 3 people in the back of the room, so... You'll like what you see with that footage.
And just as an update, remember we had told you that there was going to be the signs on the Suffolk County buses. Well, unfortunately, the lawyer from the bus company, not the person that we were in contact with,
yes.
there was an issue. Well, the New York Civil Liberties Union took our case.
Took it up.
And we're just waiting to see. We all got, everybody who's watching that did contribute
yeah.
to get a sign. You all got your money back.
It was
I did.
Too
way
political.
And they
how
felt it was too political.
How ridiculous.
But wait, because if it does come through, they're gonna be forced to pay for the sign. So that's still going on.
So that's the
just
good
wanted
news.
To let you know.
Yes, yes.
We also have on the show
I
a montage
of
from
the
parade.
Pride parade, yes.
But you can see the entire
Pride parade
and festival in the park on YouTube.
Yeah, I'm gonna edit it.
You're gonna edit
and
put it
post
on.
It up. So if you didn't make it there for the day, you'll get to see the whole march in its entirety, which was excellent this year. Very well attended.
Very well attended. The entertainment, one better than the next.
Yep.
It really was a
yeah,
good.
It was a
the
good
grand marshals, everything. It was
and
a really nice day.
Next year is the what anniversary?
20th anniversary.
Woo-hoo!
So it's going to be a lot of fun.
I already have a little sneak information on a few of the people who'll be on the stage.
Ooh.
They're not saying, though.
No, she'll tell me when we're done.
Some of the cameras off.
Then we also have another montage. She's famous for her montages.
Yes. Oh, well, we have an hour.
The drag invasion.
That's it, yes.
And that was fun this year.
It was.
It was. We just got our new equipment. And
yeah.
we were testing it out there, and you know there's some sound issues,
yeah,
but
kink
she's
sound.
Going. She's you know Sharon's going to work all that out.
That's it.
And so that's the show, really.
Yeah, basically that's the show. And if I find any other lost footage and I have time, then I'll just toss it in. That'll be the footage.
Surprise.
The footage du jour.
The footage du jour. It'll be like one from column A, one from column B,
and a
special that goes across.
That's it.
Anyway, good to see you, girl.
Good to see you, Jim. You guys. Oh, I'm sorry. You guys enjoy the show.
Sure.
We'll see you.
We'll see you.
In a few. All right. Bye bye.
Welcome to Rainbow's Edge. I'm your host, Barry Jones-Coppola. Today's guest is David Kilmnick from Long Island Gay and Lesbian Community Center. Am I right, or is it legally? I'm a little confused.
Well, it's Long Island Gay and Lesbian Youth, the Long Island GLBT Community Center, and SAGE Long Island.
Okay.
Or we could say just from the Long Island GLBT Services Network, which makes up all of
yeah.
those organizations.
Makes it a little simpler, too. So, David, how long has legally been around now?
Legally has been around since 1993, so that's 16 years.
Damn.
And it's absolutely amazing about how much the organization has evolved, how many young people have come through the program and are now doing such wonderful things, how many great leaders. Currently today we have out in the schools and out in our communities across Long Island, and just how many wonderful people throughout the years have volunteered, have helped us, and supported us in so many ways. So it's 16 years. It's sort of like a sweet 16 this year. So.
The years are flying, aren't they?
They're going by rather quick.
Certainly too quick. So what is there now? So just explain the different facets of Legally to me, please.
Sure. Well, Legally's been around for 16 years. This is many, many different education support service programs,
okay.
Social recreational programs, and mental health as well. A couple of years, or actually more than a couple of years ago, about 4 or 5 years ago, We started the process of taking a look at the needs of the greater LGBT community on Long Island, meaning above the age of 21.
Right.
And because people came to us all the time that were over the legally age of 21 and had said to us, well, what is there for us out here if we need help? What is there out here for us if we need support in terms of, you know, perhaps support groups and other types of particular health and human service type of services?
Right.
And there really wasn't that much that we could refer people to, so we started to conduct focus groups with hundreds of folks across the island, mm-hmm. and that's really how Sage Long Island developed for the elders, and also how the center developed for everyone else in between.
Right.
And so Legalese programs are for youth, young adults, and their families, and there's a ton of programs. And we could get into more specifics a little later. Sage Long Island is for people 50 and older.
Right.
That's elder. Me. Elder is 50. I know people are like 50, but yes, elder is so Sage Long Island program start at 50, and the center is for really everyone. But most of the center programs focus in on the underserved populations within our community, meaning people of color. You know, the Latino community. We have a right. program called Mango, and also the transgender community. Our light program, Long Island Trans Experience.
Very good, very good. So you must be very proud of yourself and your board of directors too. I mean, you have evolved so much. That organization has evolved so much, and it's strictly gay and lesbian, correct?
It is 24/7, 365 days a year, an LGBT organization. All of the missions of each organization is to serve and advocate for our community, and it's well, our mission and services specifically focus in on the LGBT community. The greater Long Island community gets involved, allies do, parents and families, friends, mm-hmm. corporations, politicians, local elected officials. But yes, we think it's real important to have an organization that focuses in on the needs of our community.
It's so funny that we're discussing this, because I learned that lesson the hard way, to be honest. And, you know, I'd rather my gay money go to a gay organization. So, you know, it to me, it's very important, and it really should matter to people. So what else? What else is coming up at Legally? I mean, the parade just came and passed, and everybody had a lovely time at that.
It was exciting. It was exciting. You know, we have over 30 Gay Straight Alliance clubs that marched with us during the parade, and so each year more and more young people come out, which I think is real encouraging for the future of Long Island's LGBT community, mm-hmm. Because more young people are becoming involved as leaders and getting out there, being out and visible and proud, which means that hopefully they'll stay and live on Long Island,
right.
and you know, work to take over the wonderful organizations like
exactly.
Legally the Center, Sage Long Island, and
exactly.
all the other groups.
Exactly. And yeah. to me, that's so important. And I always used to say, we really have to have like a mentoring type of thing, because it's funny, because my age bracket, when I was 17, I lived in Manhattan from like 17 to 26. So I went to school there and I lived there in Hope. You just left Long Island then. Now mm-hmm. it's like totally different because of organizations like Legally. And we do the TV show, like we did Galfoli before that. But you want these things to continue. Like, you know, we want to move away. We still have a board of directors, but at the same time, you know, we're all stage age. And, you know, we'd like the TV show to continue. So we'd like these younger people to get involved, take over the whole TV, you know, continue with Rainbow's Edge, Rainbow Connection, the whole thing, mm-hmm. you know, and it's important that we have that. So a lot of your students, are they interested in doing that?
You know, we have a lot more young people in the last couple of years that have come back to us and said they want to work for the organization,
okay. That's good.
Which is good. You know, they may be going away to school outside of Long Island, but they're saying, when I graduate, I want to come back and give back to the community that gave to me when I was growing up.
That's so important.
And so that is absolutely incredible to see. We have students each year that come back from school that do internships over the summer. We have a few this summer at the organization. So we're going to start to see a lot more native Long Islanders who grew up here, and maybe, I know it's scary to think about it, but graduated high school in the 1990s and are working to help our community.
That's so important. We'll be right back.
Here is the church. Here is the steeple. Open the doors and see all the people.
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 God accepts all the people.
All the people.
All the people.
So do we. The United Church of Christ. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you're welcome here.
All the people.
We're back, and I'm here with David Kilmnick. And David, what's your official title legally now? I'm a little confused about that. I know everything's evolved, so there must be like a...
Well, my official title is now Chief Executive Officer, or CEO, of the Long Island GLBT Services Network. And the structure that we put together for to serve our community is quite unique for across the country, really, for services to the LGBT community. Because what we did was we took Legalese reputation, Legalese expertise, but we started two other nonprofits that are separate nonprofits. They have their own employer identification number. They're each 501c3, but instead of duplicating administrative costs, we work together under one roof under the network. So therefore, we don't need three executive directors. We don't need three development departments.
Right.
We're able to better pool the resources, the minuscule resources that are given to Long Island's LGBT community, and really provide services to a lot of people. I mean, case in point is Sage Long Island,
right,
which has which officially started programs 2 years ago and has exploded in terms of the number of people accessing services. We have full-time staff that are working for Sage Long Island and the center, and those organizations are really technically only 2 years old. So the structure was one that was celebrated, if you will, by elected officials, by state government agencies, because they said that nonprofits have to think a little bit differently and be a little bit more resourceful. And now we're an example that people are trying to replicate.
Definitely. That's the main thing. Was I have friends that go to Sage and they tell me about it and they have such a wonderful time there and stuff like that. And you know, and these are people that I know like for a while, and they always had like a different life. Like they weren't like a you or a me. They weren't really out there a lot and doing a lot of things, stuff like that. But they absolutely loved that program, loved the program. So what else? Let's talk about your event for September
13th. Yes.
The first, Long Island's first gay and lesbian expo, correct?
Yes.
Did I get it right?
Yes.
Okay, so.
It's a Long Island GLBT Business and Life Expo.
Yep. Neat.
At the Holiday Inn, the Long Island Holiday Inn in Ronkonkoma, right down the road from MacArthur Airport.
Okay.
The Ravens have had many of an event,
right.
many of their parties there in March, and their anniversary parties. However, this one will be a little bit different with business booths. Set up. There are going to be vendors from all different walks of life that the LGBT community needs. Everything from taking care of your home to wedding to health. Hopefully, Way Out Media will be there broadcasting.
Yeah, of course.
And so it's going to be really a fan. There'll be entertainment. There'll be some radio stations there as well. The Long Island business community right now is real excited about this, and it's a way about bringing really all facets of Long Island life together for the LGBT community.
Especially what's going on today. I mean, like what I just was saying about keeping the gay money in the gay community, and if hopefully they passed marriage in New York, that would be like a big boom for restaurants and wedding planners. I mean, Jim and I got married in Canada, and we had our reception at Ralph with Thatch Cottage over there, but there was so much involved. I mean, we spent a fortune on flowers and everything else. I mean, there's big money. I mean, so why these states wouldn't want gay marriage? I mean, it's income for the state. I mean, mega, especially, you know, they say that gay men have, disposable incomes. I mean, mega money.
Yeah.
They would be making. So it's really exciting. I'm looking forward to going to that. And what else is going on?
Well, we have On the Bay. We don't have the date yet scheduled. We are doing it. We are doing it. I know we're a little late with coming out with the announcement, but we're trying to do something different with it this year. I think sometimes when you have an event year after year after year, it can kind of get stale.
Yeah, you got to pump life and sort of, exactly.
You know, you got to, you know, reinvent it in a way. So,
absolutely.
You know, our reinvention's taken a little bit longer this year, but we will have it, and it will be, you know, fun again. It'll be a lawn and auction party, but we're working out the location, and so that will be in August. So stay tuned on our website, I don't know if I gave four W's, but three W's, www.legally.org, LIGALY.org, or you can, of course, see it on the Sage Long Island site or the center as well.
And I noticed, like, online that you have an e-zine, like a newsletter online now, too, which is very, very informative. I mean, I wouldn't you send that out every couple of weeks, I believe, isn't it?
We send it out every 2 weeks.
I saw one today, as a matter of fact.
Yeah. Yeah, we send it out every 2 weeks to keep the community informed about what's going on and what they can get involved in and what may be available to them, especially through, in the most recent e-newsletters that we've had. Mm-hmm. It's been renewal time for businesses involved in our Partners in Pride
right.
business networking program.
Okay.
So some of our businesses are offering big discounts on things that would people need in the summer, like landscaping, masonry, pools,
Strong.
Things like that. So, because really as, for those about out there watching who are homeowners, you want to make sure that, we want to give our hard-earned money to people that support our community.
Sure.
And so it's important because everybody that joins Partners in Pride, I mean, they get great access to the LGBT community. We have over 17,000 people on our mailing list. So certainly that's, access to a market that, yeah. that most people would want. But at the same time, they're committing to, and they're pledging to helping our young people. They're committing to help fight bullying in schools, to create safer schools. They're committing to help create safer spaces for families. They're helping to, provide important health and wellness programs for our seniors. So it's Long Island giving back, and therefore we know that if we call someone to come over our house for an estimate that, most likely they're going to be very safe and supportive.
It sounds wonderful. I mean, it seems like you thought of everything, and for years I've been saying it's all about evolving, and it's not about sustaining an organization, it's about evolving the organization. So, like I said, you've worked wonders, and I thank you for joining us today, and we'll see you over the summer. We'll definitely see you at On the Bay, and we'll definitely see you at the Gay and Lesbian Expo in September.
Yes.
And have a good summer.
Thank you. You too.
Hello, my name is Betty DeGeneres, and my kid is the greatest. You know her. She's Ellen, and she's gay. For too long, gay Americans have suffered discrimination. As long as our sons and daughters are excluded from the basic protection of law, we must share that burden as a family. So let's not waste one child, and let them all reach for the stars.
The marriage equality legislation that's before the state legislature now. I want to make sure that we don't have to have our legislator, John Cooper, and his longtime partner go to Connecticut to get married. They should be allowed to get married right here in New York State. That there was a beautiful picture on the front page of the Stanford Times.
Hi, Jack.
And John and Robert, what was it, last week?
No, you don't have to.
April 30th. On their 29th anniversary. So please, whatever you can, please urge our state legislators to support Governor Patterson's marriage equality legislation.
Hear, hear.
And the state assembly passed the bill.
Yes! Yes! 89-57! And if you can't anything, can you feel?
Global warming. Some say irreversible consequences are 30 years away. 30 years? That won't affect me.
To move out in front.
How festive are you guys?
Great. Oh.
Happy Pride.
Hi, kids.
Sit and putter. Life's candy and the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring around a cloud to rain on my parade.
Ladies and gentlemen, he has been on the board of directors of Annie and Cunningham for over 8 years and is treasurer for 7.
Yeah!
dance floor. Something's drawing me closer to you. I'm coming over, yeah, I'm walking on through. And I just can't keep my eyes off of you. The way I move, I lose control. My music's pumping deep within my soul. It's hypnotizing, so mesmerizing. Rhythm's thumping, there's no denying. Come and see what I mean. I'm gonna make you believe this is your day. What's your destiny, Long Island? It's equality. What's your destiny?
Priscilla Pride here at the 19th Annual Long Island Pride Parade here in Huntington. And I have the privilege of sitting with Suffolk County Legislative Majority Leader John Cooper.
Hi, kids.
Hi. Listen, John, okay, a lot of exciting things happening. First and foremost, let's get the crap out of the way of what's going on in the Senate with all this stuff of two Democrats with the Republicans and yada, 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 yada. What's happening?
I asked you to explain it to me.
Well, I don't know. I get very angry, and I hear on the news there's one from the Bronx who is really ticking off his constituency, and they want to oust him. They want to get him out, but the only way to get him out, kids, is you got to vote him out. That's the problem. But apparently,
and that's a long-term solution.
But the deal is, from what I'm hearing, it could also be a ploy that if he is one person, if they have 31 votes, and he could then sway it because he wouldn't vote with them. It's all a game. I don't know.
Well, it's a pretty sad game, actually. Unfortunately, the New York State Legislature has not had a stellar reputation in recent years, and this is a true embarrassment. But unfortunately, it affects real lives.
Sure.
And it's held up some major legislation at the end of the session.
That's what I heard. Yes.
Including
same-sex marriage. Correct. Now, which if that doesn't happen this year, we think it could happen next year, but the whole process has to start all over again for it to happen.
I really do believe that if it does come for a vote in the state Senate, that it will pass, because there's a growing recognition on the part of all the state senators that this is history unfolding before their eyes, and this is a vote that they're going to have to justify to their children and grandchildren.
Sure.
So I think at the end of the day, enough hearts and minds will be swayed that the bill will pass.
It's about time. I mean, separate, equal, not separate rights. That's what we're talking about. And this has got to just stop. The whole, we didn't put it out there. It was Bush's administration that started this crap. And then now everybody's getting on the bandwagon. No, no, no. Give me a break. Equal, not separate rights, for crying out loud.
Well, that's why my spouse, Rob, and I got tired of waiting for New York. The New York State Legislature to get their act together, and this past April 30th, on our 29th anniversary, we decided to get married, so we popped up to Greenwich, Connecticut, and we were legally wed.
The First Lady of Huntington, Rob, I love her. She's fabulous. She was there for me when I came out and did my first little drag at the Outlook Awards. She was so supportive. But we wouldn't be at the Huntington Long Island Pride Parade if it wasn't chock full of rumor has it you're putting an exploratory committee together for running for U.S. Senate, possibly.
Yes.
What's going on?
I formed the exploratory committee six weeks ago, and now I'm traveling the state.
Okay.
I'm popping up to Albany on Tuesday, going down to D.C. for some meetings. So I'm moving forward with the exploratory campaign. I'm meeting with voters. I'm meeting with Democratic clubs, elected officials. But so far, I've got to say the feedback has been amazing.
Now, I've seen in the press, I've seen President Obama, who you were the biggest supporter for him. I remember way back when I was standing there going, Hillary Clinton, and I asked my questions, but I came on your bandwagon. I did. I believe in him. I've seen in the papers President Obama saying to this one, saying to that one, Mr. Israel, blah, 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 don't, Carol McCarthy, don't. Has he been supportive of you possibly putting this campaign together?
I've read the same stories that you've read in the paper about calls to Steve Israel or some of the others, but all I know is that Barack hasn't called me.
All right, so there you go. Now, it would be a landmark because you would be the first openly gay U.S. senator.
Correct.
That's monumental, kids. That's all I'm going to say. But if you need more information, if you want to know more about it, if you want to talk to John, please go to www.cooperfornewyork.com. CooperFornewYork.com. John, thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of the day. We really appreciate it. And we do want you back on the show as things occur in your campaign. All right.
Thank you.
Thanks, kids.
Thanks.
We live life, how shall I put it? On an angle. Take a deep breath, a sip of champagne, and open your eyes. What do you see? It's rather gaudy, but it's also rather grand. And while the waiter pads your check, he'll kiss your hand. The clever gigolos romance the wealthy matrons at La Page aux Poules. It's slightly 40s and a little bit new wave. You may be dancing with a girl who needs a shave, where both the riffraff and the royalty are patrons at La Cage aux Folles. La Cage aux Folles. The maitre d' is dashing, Cage aux Folles. The hat check girl is flashing. We import the drinks that you buy, so your Perrier is Canada Dry. Eccentric couples always punctuate the scene. A pair of eunuchs and a nun with a marine. To feel alive, you get a limousine to drive you to La Cage aux Folles. I know a duchess who got pregnant at the bar. Just who is who and what is quite a question at La Cage aux Folles. Go for the mystery, the magic, and the mood. Avoid the hustlers
and the men's room
and the food. For you get glamour and romance and indigestion at La Cage aux Folles. La Cage aux Folles. All week long we're wondering who left a green.
Check it out, man.
What is that?
It looks like someone's belly. Yeah, probably lost it walking on the beach.
Man, just leave it. Let's go.
This is fine. Thanks.
Okay.
proud to witness history in the gay, lesbian, bisexual, and transgender community, ladies and gentlemen. Without further ado, Miss Priscilla Pride.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Priscilla Pride!
Because we're actually revealing the plans and we're building the largest gay and lesbian church in the New England area. And we want you guys to be part of it.
And I thought, you know, Stephen really deserves recognition. There aren't very many people that have been involved in the community the entire time that I have. A lot of people kind of come and go, and they get very involved, and then they get burnt out. And Stephen has been there, you know, as well, longer than I have, and it's been great working with you. I am thrilled every time that you call me, even if I can't always do it, to come to the Rainbow Connection TV show and give my opinions on the latest political wranglings of the day. What's really important about what Stephen has done is that being on cable access TV, people are exposed to the gay and lesbian community, that the gay, lesbian, bisexual, and transgender community that don't pick up Outlook, that aren't at the bars, and aren't picking up the publications that we're putting out there for our community. And I know, because people have come up to me and when I'm with Stephen, and they'll say, hey, I know you. They're not talking to me, they're talking to him. And you know, including political figures in Nassau and Suffolk County that are aware of Stephen and the other people on the show, you know, because when you're flicking through the channels late at night, there's a good chance that you're gonna see Stephen. And I'm always kind of interested, I guess is the word, at the people that actually stop and watch the show. And I know Stephen has shared that story with me as well, and it's like, wow, you're really into the Rainbow Connection. That's cool.
Thank you so much for this award. I'm truly humbled, and thank you for playing that song. It's so cute. When I was told I was getting the Lifetime Achievement Award, my first reaction was, you know something about my life expectancy that I don't. But it is a lifetime that I've been doing the show. Like I said, we completed 15 years on public access. It's kind of hard to believe. And we're going to do it for at least another 15. Because it is so super critical that we have a voice, we have a say. And if we can make the world a better place for people who are lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender, that's what it's all about at the end of the day. And I'm very privileged that I was able to turn my struggle into a career and to help to advocate and help other people. So for all of you, if you take anything from this tonight, the personal is political. Continue to come out to the people that you know to be who you are so that one day, you know, we won't need, you know, to fight for our rights. It'll just be a given. And I hope that one day we look back at this time and think, how could there be a time when we discriminated against people who are lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender? So thank you. Thank you so much. And of course I have the nominees for the Entertainer of the Year. And the winner is, you ready, Johnny? And the Entertainer of the Year is Ariel Sinclair. Ariel, congratulations, sweetheart.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you. I want to thank Tom and Outlook Magazine. I am so honored to be a drag queen in this community of Long Island. I could not do this without the love and support of my family, my brother, my sister-in-law are here. Give it up for them. Yes. And all my friends, thank you so much. Thank you for coming to the show, supporting all the drag. Drag is not dead on Long Island. Put your pumps on, put your wigs on. Come on, people, come on. Are you having fun? Thank you so much. Good night.
I have a distinct honor of awarding the best local media, and the winner is Way Out Media. Yeah!
Thank you very much, everybody. We're very honored to receive this. As you know, the Rainbow Connection has been on the air for 15 years, and we're thrilled that our sister show, Rainbow's Edge, has joined us, and we hope to continue to bring fantastic media that highlights issues that impact our community. And taking it to the next level and bringing it to the web and doing even more of that. So we're looking forward to doing that. So thank you so much. And we did want to also acknowledge and accept this award in memory of our board member, Barry Jones, recently lost his sister, Janice. So we just wanted to do that for him as well.
In memory of Janice Jones Fiore, but one other thing, in case we don't win Best Business, I don't care, I'm doing it now. United Business Media, my parent company where I work for, just awarded grants around the country. And Way Out Media just received $14,000 from Hudson. In these tough times, it'll help us with equipment, it'll help us do PSAs against Stop the Violence Against Women and Girls and other roundtable discussions. So Way Out Media is here to stay, kids. Yeah! Congratulations.
Priscilla Pride, presenting Volunteer of the Year. Now, all right, calm down. Shh. Thank you. This is a very important award, I feel, because I won it one year. And it really shows the 1, 2, 3, 4 nominees work very hard and tireless for their organizations, and without them and without the other volunteers that do make up this community, we would really have a very sad community. So, our 4 nominees, hardworking, are Sharon Gillen, yay, Bill Hahn, Eva Sanchez, and Mr. Carlos Serrano. I'm going to put the microphone down while I try to open this with my nails. And the winner is... I got to make
it. All right.
You guys are crazy.
I am proud. Sharon Gillen! My co-host is from Rainbow Dash! Sharon! Oh, honey, well deserved.
Oh, wow. Thank you very much. It's nice to be recognized, and I share this with all of the volunteers in the room, because without us, really, nothing would be getting done in our community. So I would just like to say one thing. If you've never volunteered, whether it be in the gay community or to go to a nursing home or pick a cause, any cause, believe me, you will get more out of it than you put into it, because it is a wonderful return. Go and talk to some old people in a nursing home. They have great things to say. And this is dedicated to my mom and dad, who are no longer with me, but who modeled for me what it is and to give back to the community. And also to my sister Lois, who is always there to support me from thick and thin. So I thank all of you. Tom, thank you. And that's it.
My co-host is on Rainbow's Edge. I'm so proud. Wait till the next show. I'm going to rib you, girl. All right.
And I'm proud to announce that the activist of the year for 2008 is Miss Julie Owens.
Yay, Julie!
Well, the first mistake you made was handing an activist a microphone. I do want to take just a second, first of all, and thank Outlook Long Island for this wonderful honor. And also, everyone in the room and everyone that voted for me, I really appreciate it. I do have a couple things I want to tell you, if we could just take a second. Because again, being an activist, it's like selling the problem, selling the program, and trying to get people on board. I'm very concerned about marriage equality. I'm very concerned about dignity for all students. But I am very, 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 very concerned about transgender rights. And the best way for me to convey this information to you is I'd like to just give you 3 quick little scenarios. Okay, so if you would, I'm going to get into my act, so let me try and do it. As a human resources manager of this company, I pick who we hire. I'm very uncomfortable with transgender people. So I make sure we don't hire them. Number 2. I know we have available apartments, but our rule is that we don't rent apartments to trans people. That's our rule. Sorry. You've told me 10 times that your children are hungry, but we don't supply food stamps to people like you. I would send you to the homeless shelter, but they don't allow trannies either. It's clear that as you listen to these statements, they're hateful, biased, and unfair. No one in today's world would ever say these things to people, would they? The amazing thing is that they can legally be said in the 21st century in the very liberal blue state of New York. How can we allow this type of behavior to remain acceptable for any group, for any community of people? You have honored me today with this very special award, but I challenge everyone here to do something which requires more work, more commitment, more love. Starting today, join with the New York State transgender community and help us pass the Gender Bill, which is the Gender Expression Non-Discrimination Act. Please help us care for the one remaining community of people who can be openly discriminated against. Please help us take care of our transgendered sisters and brothers. Thank you all so very much.
Hey, we're back.
It's the end.
It's the end.
Another end. Another great show.
Another fabulous show. I just want to give a real fast shout out to Teresa and Steve and Lisa. Thanks for watching. You're
yes,
so fabulous.
All the time.
They're related through blood. We won't go there.
All right.
Please don't make the other
but
one
we
watch
thank
it. You
for
know who
watching.
I mean. But anyway, thank you because you have wonderful support.
And to everyone else that tunes in.
Yes. Now.
Wait. We wanted to remember to say on this show about the YouTube. If you don't have cable,
that's right.
You can see us
okay,
on YouTube,
well, wait
and it will
if
be
you,
posted.
Okay, now that was just a blonde.
No, to tell the friend.
That was just a blonde lesbian thing. If you don't have cable, watch us on YouTube. How are you going to know if you don't have cable? Because you won't
friends,
be seeing us.
Tell
your friends.
Tell your friends.
To go on to YouTube. YouTube.com and you'll see our shows. I mean, come on. But
oh,
also,
you know
go
what?
To
I have to give him props. It was a blonde moment.
It was a blonde
but
moment.
But I did mean tell your friends.
Hello. But also we have to tell them, go to www.wayoutmedia.org to look up our sponsors.
Yes, for
they're
both shows.
Wonderful supporters for both Rainbow's Edge and for the
Rainbow's
Long Island
Connection.
Rainbow Connection.
Right.
And they've been tremendous supporters all along. So, Cher, I'll see
Jim,
you in another 6 weeks.
See you in another one. All right.
Bye, all.
Ta-ta.